Many of you knew Jane Frank. She fell in love with that land, and this is one reason why so many people are trying so hard to preserve it. And we want to say a very special thank you to Sutu and all of the musicians who are here today. Why don't you give them all a big round of applause? I think there's probably 30 or 35 musicians who are here today that are going to just play their hearts out. It is. And of course, you know, the reason we're here is to try and save that precious wildlife preserve, 37 acres. And I believe there's a satellite image of it over there. It's 37 acres on the east side of Hingston Creek off of Old 63 at the end of the Bumpdale cul-de-sac. And the vision of its wild nature is to have a safe haven for all the animals, for all the people, and for the trees and the grass and the land. You know, the little animals that we are displacing every day were here long before human beings were. Long before the settlers from Europe came and displaced the Native American. And now we're doing that to the animals. So there's 37 acres that can be preserved, but it takes money and it takes effort to do that. The purpose of today is to try to raise $50,000 so they can pay off that land by Christmas time. They've already raised $117,000.
Well on their way, not done yet.
So they need to raise another $50,000, and you can help with that by being as generous as you can. I believe you can donate in cash, in check, or with PayPal through your phone.
Thank you, Paul and Dave. Good afternoon. I'm Charlie Nylon, and Chief of the School of Natural Resources, and I'm here to talk about what It's Our Wild Nature is and the site. So about 10 years ago, Sutu and Barbara introduced me to It's Our Wild Nature site, which is formerly called It's Our Wild Nature Sanctuary and Altus Nature School. And this is a 37-acre site where you have the opportunity to be immersed in nature, to walk down the street and step into the natural world. So that's really important. People have contact with nature, and it's something that all of us can do. You can drive on Bluffdale or enter the Bluffdale cul-de-sac and see this site. So what you'll see will be a mix of forest and some mature tree species and some species that kind of are along the sides of streams. You'll see about 40 species of birds. You went outside this time of year, you've got 40 bird species there. So it's a beautiful site. But it's also a site that It's Our Wild Nature is trying to purchase and protect. So as Paul and James mentioned, they're trying to raise $50,000 to buy Christmas to help pay for the purchase of the site. There are also other ways you can be involved. Every Saturday, there's an opportunity to go out and participate and help me restore the site, to pull invasive species and to plant the native species which occur in Mid-Missouri. So if you're interested in this, on the back table back there, there's a sign-up sheet for two different groups. First group is It's Our Wild Nature. If you're interested in fundraising and helping plan all the activities on the site, that's a great organization, and you can put down your name and email address. If you're interested in participating more in the restoration and how the site can be restored and maintained over time, there's a group called the Shepherd to Rollins Restoration Collaborative, and it meets every Wednesday on Zoom, and every once in a while we actually meet in person out there, and there's a sign-up sheet for that, and they're also the folks who coordinate the planting and removing exotic species on Wednesdays. So remember that this afternoon you have a chance to participate in the silent auction. You have a chance to make contributions to Soil Wild Nature. All those things will be helpful in getting folks outside and enjoying a unique place right here in Columbia. So now it's my privilege to introduce Audra Serbel, who is the music director for the Unity Center.
Thank you, Charlie. Thank you all so much for coming today. It's really lovely to see so many familiar and wonderful faces and some new faces here in Unity of Columbia. We are honoring It's Our Wild Nature here today, and there, I think that Paul and James already told you that there is a silent auction over here and people taking money, so please take a gander at that, yay. And you can sign up for volunteer involvement for the sanctuary as well over there. So the sanctuary is at the end of Bluffdale Drive off of Old 63, and it's along the Hinson Creek. And I just got a chance to go with Sutu and enjoy that space for the first time since they really put in the big trail and the big bridge. I admit that Sutu and I have walked maybe in the sanctuary at least 50 times together, and I knew my way around. But this time when I went to visit for the first time after they put everything in, I was very disoriented. And I imagined what it would have felt like for the animals while they went through all of that with the construction, and I imagined what it would be like for a new animal to come into that space. It was really, it was disconcerting and alarming how different it was, and the sounds, and how different it was just for me as a human. And so I thought about all the animals, and I'm really grateful that Sutu and everyone here today is coming together for us to take its small spaces. That's the way that we're going to make this revolution happen, is by reclaiming small spaces that we all care about. Because unfortunately, the big ones are getting taken over by corporations. So here's our chance to have something in Columbia that we can all say, we come together and we want to stand up for this piece of land and the animals and the habitat here. And leading the charge for so long is Sutu Forte, a wonderful, amazing musician, but also the person that has the largest heart that I think I've ever seen or been witness to. And I'm grateful to be loved by her. I'm grateful to love her. And I'm super grateful to have her present her program, Wild. So introducing Sutu Forte.
Thank you. up in chains. I know I've been chained. I know I've been chained. Angels in heaven.
God bless this tree. Now I must cut down. Let it fall across the stream that I might reach my way around now. Like my brother told me before I was a man. He said, when you feel like you're near the end, you'll do just what you can. Standing on a stump, or floating down the stream, it don't really matter where you are, just a part of the same dream. It don't really matter where you are, just a part of the same old dream.
Yep.
Thank you.
By Jovi Coy's Happy Birds. Unicorn. When the sun goes down.
Today. I just don't don't see a lot of other people sitting in trees these days. And I feel really honored. Singing our heart song.
This is called For the Green Room, and it was penned in 1988. Sake of wealth and greed, the beauty of the forest gone, no more shall they get seed. Oh green, beautiful green, not by our children seen. And if my blood runs red as fire, I'll give it for the green. See, the sun does know thee well. In all your cities, on all your lands, your people there do dwell. Oh green, beautiful green, we must never let it fail. Oh dreams, our beautiful dreams, on your wings of hope we sail. In in all your cities, on all your lands, your people there do dwell. Ah, green, oh green, yes, beautiful green, we must never let it fail. Our dreams, oh dreams, yes, beautiful dreams, on your wings of hope we sail.
By Robert Service, who wrote turn of the 1800s, 1900s in the Yukon. He wrote a lot of nature poems, a lot of poems about nature. This is Trees Against the Sky by Robert Service. Pines against the sky, pluming the purple hill. Pines, and I wonder why, heart you quicken thrill. Wistful heart of a boy filled with a strange, sweet joy, lifting to heaven high, pines against the sky, palms against the sky, flailing the hot, hard blue, stark on the beach, I lie dreaming, horizons new, heart of my youth, elate, scorning a humdrum fate. Key to adventure high, palms against the sky, oaks against the sky, ramparts of leaves high hurled, staunch to stand, defile the winds of the world, stalwart, proud, and free, firing the man in me to try, and again to try, oaks against the sky. Olives against the sky of evening, limpidly bright, tranquil, soft, and shy, dreaming in amber light, breathing the peace of life, ease after toil and strife, hark to their silver sigh, olives against the sky. Cypresses blooming the sky, stark at the end of the road, failing and faint am I, leaf to be eased of my load. There, where the stones peer white in the last of the silvery light, quiet and cold all lie, cypresses etching the sky. Trees, trees against the sky. Oh, I have loved them well. There are pleasures you cannot buy, treasures you cannot sell. And not the smallest of these is the gift and glory of trees. So I gaze, and I know now why it's good to live and to die. Trees.
Afternoon. I'm going to introduce myself a little bit because I'm doing something completely different. My name is Victoria Day, and I'm a somatic movement therapist and an embodiment activist and artist. And we are halfway through this incredible event, and Sutu has asked me to do something just a little different. We are going to create a movement art piece together. I'm the founder of something called the Mandala Community Movement Project. And what we do is we create pieces with non-dancers, non-movers, that are significant in the moment, and then like the sand mandala, it's all gone. So this is in five pieces. There's five movements. The first time around, I'm gonna focus on me. And so if you just wanna watch, but if you feel inspired, you can start throwing in right in the beginning. The second time around, we are going to move. We. The third time, you are going to move, and I'm going to be your deep sacred witness. So I just want to invite all of you to just let your breath go. Your wild, wild breath. It knows what to do. You don't have to control it. I'm going to invite you to let your voice go. It might be a teeny weeny yawn. It might be a sigh. It could be a moan. It could be a yip. Let's try that again. Let your breath go. And you are all sitting, so I'm just going to invite you to let yourself feel your body as if you've never sat before. This is the first time you've ever sat in a chair. Feel the earth coming up through your feet, coming up through your pelvic floor. Be alive, move, let go of your position. Find a different way to be in this chair so that you are really in your chair. And if you want to choose to stay in your chair through this whole 5 minutes, please do. But if you want to join me by standing, I invite you to trust the earth, trust the wildness of the earth, to let you push against it so that you can rise up, stand up, come on. Oh, okay, and we begin. I am the wild tree, from the deep roots to the tips of my leaves. I am the wild bird, free from wingtip to wingtip. I am the wild squirrel, from my wiggly tail to my quivery nose. I am the approaching wild storm, big and loud and electric. I am the wild me, full of sound and movement. We are the wild trees, from the depth of our roots to the tips of our leaves. Let your breath go. We are the wild birds. Feel the freedom from wingtip to wingtip. Oh! We are the wild squirrels, full of life. Let your tails wiggle. Let your noses quiver. We are the wild storm, approaching big, loud, electric. We are the wild, full of sound and movement. Show me what you got. Oh, and let your breath go. Feel your feet on the ground, because now I am your witness. You are the wild trees, from the depths of your roots up to the tips of your leaves. Oh. You are the wild birds, free from wingtip to wingtip. Oh. You are the wild squirrels, full of life. Let me see that tail. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Let me see your noses quiver. You are the wild storms. Big, approaching, loud, electric. You are the wild things. Full of sound and movement. Just show me something. What do you got? Let me see it. Come on. It can be small. It can be big. Let go of those positions. Let go of your breath. It is our wild nature. It is ever present if we allow it.
I'm telling a story about my father. My father was 92 years old. He passed away in January. The last 2 years, or last 2 weeks of his life, he was at home. He was buck naked. Now, Daddy didn't wear a lot of clothes anyway. This is a story about the springtime, not the fall, even though we're in turkey hunting season. This was in turkey season. Needless to say, we bought a couple of lots, and they were kind of wild, and we had some cornfields, so we ordered 1,000 trees, and we started planting trees. Well, one morning I get up, and I go for a walk, and I find a turkey nest full of eggs. I was so excited, I come running back to the house to tell Dad about it. Well, Dad's got on, it was a nice warm day, he had on a pair of jersey shorts, and that's it. No shoes. We never wore shoes. No shoes, and we hiked it back out to the woods. Well, by the time we get there, the turkey is on the nest. So we just hunkered down and watched her for a bit. And I told him, I says, hey, Pop, over on the other ridge is a cistern, a water cistern from an old homestead. He said, well, let's go see that. So we kind of trek over that way. And we sat in front of it, and we looked at all the animal tracks that still come to this live cistern, which is, a cistern is a watering hole. People got their water from these back in the day. So we're on our way back down the hill to the house, and we're just walking along, taking in springtime, and a Jake turkey flies right up off the ground, whoop, whoop, right beside my dad. My dad, scrawny, long hair, barely clad, goes, oh my God, and takes off running as fast as he can, down the hill, through the blackberries, everything, go, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, and I just sit down laughing. I'm thinking, what on earth? So I get down to the house, still laughing, and I said, what in the world, Pop? He goes, I didn't know what it was, but it wasn't going to catch me.
Thank you. author, Miki Masome, Tuturna Aliki Zumra, Hearly.
Thank you. sky and sea. You are inside and all around me.
It's stronger if we all sing, so join in if you can.
Oh, great spirit, earth, wind, sky, and sea, you are inside and all around me.
Come on now.
Oh, great spirit, earth, wind, sky, and sea, you are. So what do we do with this healing power, this magnificent power we have? We walk in harmony with all things, with all life. Or as the Navajo Diné put it, the beauty way, walking in beauty. I walk in beauty before me. I walk in beauty behind me. I walk in beauty above me. I walk in beauty below me. I walk in beauty all around me. As I walk the beauty way, I walk in beauty all around me. As I walk my life the beauty way. And if you want to imbue this into your actions, your words, and your thoughts, you can join me with the motions, even if your voice doesn't seem to want to sing, but that's good too. May all my actions be beautiful. Hope. May all my words be beautiful. Hope. May all my thoughts be beautiful, hope, as I walk my life the beauty way. I walk in beauty all around me. As I walk the beauty way, I walk in beauty all around me. As I walk my life the beauty way. And then we have Chief Seattle. And again, some of you may find that it's easy to sing along, because in this one I repeat the words. Each line is repeated. So it's a call and response. And we can pretend that's part of the storm that Sutu is evoking in her music. Every part of the earth is sacred to my people. Every part of the earth is sacred to my people. We are part of the earth, and she is part of us. We are part of the earth, and she is part of us. All things share the same breath. 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 This we know, the earth does not belong to us. We belong to the earth. This we know, the earth does not belong to us. We belong to the earth. You have another chance. Every part of the earth is sacred to my people. Every part of the earth is sacred to my people. We are part of the earth, and she is part of us. We are part of the earth, and she is part of us. All things share the same breath. 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 This we know, the earth does not belong to us. We belong to the earth. This we know, the earth does not belong to us. We belong to the earth. Repeat, we belong to the earth. 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 Oh.
And if you notice that my pants are wet, it is not my wild nature taking over. It's just water. Sutu tried to baptize me back there. Okay, so I'm going to be a rebel. I'm going to start off with a little piece of something. So we're outside and we're enjoying the weather. And everybody's looking up here. And I don't want to be the star right now. So I want everybody just to look up and enjoy the wild nature. Because sometimes we forget to look up and see the clouds and see how cool it looks when the wind hits the trees and how it all moves. It's beautiful. So while you enjoy that, I'm going to do a little piece of something, and then I'm going to actually do my song. Oh, Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the world thy hands have made, I view the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. I was born by the river in a little tent, and oh, just like that river I've been running ever since. It's been a long, long time coming, but I know my brother, in my Oh, brother, won't you help me, please? Don't you know that he winds up knocking me down? Beyond the skies, it's been a long time coming, but I know a change is gonna come. Oh, yes it will.
Thank you.
You ain't seen nothing like this. Yeah, the last time I was out, you know, it was like 2012, and it was like in Sutu's backyard, and like folks were saying like I was extinct, but I wasn't extinct. I was just chilling. So it's like, you know, they're calling me extinct, but you know, I'm an animal. But I got hygiene. I'm not extinct.
Right.
So
we'll have to send her the video.
She wanted to come out here and talk about, you know, what it's like for the animals that are wanting this place, this beautiful place to be. And so I'm here to tell you, we as like the animals, we need this kind of place that's not there's no concrete, there's no streetlights, you know, where there's lots of fresh green, like grass and bushes and beautiful trees and stuff, because we need this stuff for our babies to go. And you guys, maybe you don't know it or not, but you guys, in your fair city, but like it's our fair city, because I mean, let's face it, we were here first, right? So in our fair city, we need places like this. So they're talking to me, they're saying, you know what it takes to do this, it takes money. And I'm like, money? I'm an animal. What are you talking about, money? I ain't got pockets. I'm not having money, I ain't got no pockets. But you guys got pockets. You guys got money. And that's what we need for this, because you guys can make this happen.
awesome.